but I'm slowly, so for 10 years it was just the main camp. 2001 we built the bush camp, in 2006 we built the suites and the villa. So they went from killing these animals, because they were cattle farmers. When the leopard killed your cattle, you killed the leopard. That was the known thing as a farmer. To then asking why. Why are we not solving that? Why is there no solution? So then Wayne, who is the visionary of Akhtima, actually, he's the only brother, and he questioned that and started the research. So then he started loving these animals. From killing them, he said, well, I need to protect you now. Which was good, because you're now saving a life. But in saving a life, they were habituating. So you'll see a lot of pictures of Wayne with the leopard cub, and Don and Rosie with the lion. And so yes, they were saving that life. But it had to go through another step. And that step was, yes, that life is saved, but what quality of life does that lion have? And the answer was, not its real life. Its real life is life in the wild. And that's why the development of the park came across. So this is now almost the third phase of thinking. So it's taken, you know, all these generations to learn all of that. So now in this third phase, it's all about protection of species. How are we going to do that? Not just by saving one life and making it safe and cuddling it. It's not about that. It's about conservation in the bigger perspective, the holistic perspective, in the sense of conservation out in the wild. And yes, there's some that we can save and they can live a natural life, but how do we make a bigger impact than just here? And that's where the education comes in. Yeah. So the generations have differed in their thinking, but only from learning from the previous generation can we get to the thinking that we're at. And we truly believe in the thinking that we're at the moment. We want to show you life in the wild, life in the park. Instead of come stroke the tita, that's super nice and cute. Yeah. So, yeah. In essence, the thinking of over the generations has been very, very different. But that's how we've got to where we are now today. Akhtima was just this, and then we got a few more farms then to what we now created is a Greater Akhtima Nature Reserve, and that's now 20,000 hectares of parkland where we've done this restoration of the habitat and restoration of the ecosystem from the cattle farming days now to a nature reserve days. And so as you see it now, it stands this big, which looks pretty big, and you've been into the park and you've seen it. But if you look at how vast Namibia is, it's not very big. So these farmers face this battle of leopards, cheetahs killing their cattle. They kill the cheetah and the leopard. So here is mainly the leopard and the cheetah that we face the problem with. And in the north is more with lions and the wild dogs. Here in this Mangetti strip in like a preview. The Tosha fence line has holes in it. So now you have the lion coming out, and over here you have all these communal farmers. If your cow is your livelihood and the lion kills your cow, you know, then what? You kill the lion. And that's seen as a success story. And culturally in Namibia and in Africa, I mean, you look at all these warriors killing the lions, that's when you get, for instance, something like this, where from a young age, these children are taught that that is a good thing. I mean, the same as us, Little Red Riding Hood, kill the wolf, yay. You know, that's conflicting. That's her project up in the north, trying to protect these lions, trying to chase them back into the park when they can, trying to educate these communities not to kill, but rather to live together in a clever way, for instance, crawling at night. The main focus is on education, because only through educating children and adults or guests and can we make that difference in a bigger picture. Because Namibia has a population of about 2.2 million. If we're going to make a difference, it's going to be here. So this evolution of the work that Africa's done has changed that focus. And now it's from what we can research in order to educate, specifically the children. Adults are very stubborn and don't want to change their attitudes. So the children is the key to changing the future. AfriCat has a welfare center, which is in the middle over there. where there's different camps, and the camps are about 25 hectares. We will, for instance, the cheetahs that you found, we group them together and then we release them into the park. If we can one day tell you that there's no cats in welfare, we'll be very excited, because we don't advertise this. This is a necessary stepping stone. We don't believe that life should be like this. We believe life should be in the wild, running free. But the cats that are in welfare, by law, we have to do an annual veterinary check and health check. And this clinic was donated to us by Jimmy Malton, and he left a legacy. We'll always continue our work, even with the small clinic that we did have, but this clinic just allows us to do that much more. A farmer shoots one leopard. Why is that not solving the problem? Because the next week, there's another one killing his cattle. And that, a collar allows us that research, and it shows us, for instance, that yes, that farmer shot one, but that means the territory is open, so two more will come in. So this is a necessary thing for us. These kids, a lot of them are more educated than their families, than their parents. Plus minus 65 children, 5 full-time teachers, where we've been, you know, very lucky to have built these amazing classroom facilities. Again, it's all about education. Education is what's making the difference. Because if we can reach a class of 20 children, then they can reach their adults and say, hey daddy, why did you shoot that lion? Parents have their kids wrapped around their fingers. And then they can think differently. And the same as if we can get teachers here. Say you get a group of 20 teachers, then they can influence their classes of 20, and you know, so forth. The conservation message is carried on.